Where I left off was I added a couple of, I added altogether 4 cups of flour, and I mixed the flours, and I added some bread flour and high protein wheat flour. Then I added a cup of my pulp, and I basically keep my pulp in the freezer after I use the peelings for the persimmon. I use the peelings and I make the actual yeast water with it. And then I take my pulp, I put it in there, and then I add about, I'd say a half a teaspoon of salt. You can add a little bit more salt if you want. But what salt does, it keeps the yeast from growing. And I added like maybe a teaspoon, or you can add like a teaspoon or 2 teaspoons of sugar. You got, this is honey, and honey has yeast in it as well. And yeah, who knew? Oops. And then I got about a teaspoon, I'd say about a half a teaspoon of instant, and then I heated up some water, which is in here. I heated up a little bit of water, just a little tiny bit, and then maybe a half a teaspoon, and that'll help it. So that's how you make the sourdough. You basically make it out of, but you don't have to use the instant yeast if you're using wild yeast, which is pretty cool. And then so I think this is a good bread. What I'm gonna do is take it out on my clean bench here and kind of work with it. Okay, kind of work with it, make sure. Kind of bring everything together. Now, I used to make bread in high school, but we used the dry yeast. And then plus this has got, so I'm considering, this has the pulp in it, so I'm considering the pulp to be like a form of liquid. So, and plus I have my wild yeast and just a little bit of that staff, you know. And then this is going to be, covered in my, make sure it's in a nice warm area, or if your place is cold, if you like me and you like keeping your home nice and cool, and cover it up, and then you can put it in the oven, cover it up and put it in the oven, and then just kind of make sure you put oil in, you know, I'll show you in a minute. It's okay to taste it too. Remember when you were a kid and you ate raw dough? I'm talking about all the adults out there. My mom, I used to love eating raw dough. My mother would tell me, "No, you're gonna get sick." And this is a wonderful grain. This is a wonderful thing to do with your kids, in your daycare, if you have a daycare. This is like really awesome. If you want to have a bread party, this would be great. And bring that into a ball. So what I'm doing, I'm basically getting the glutens together, gathering them together. It's a nice workout as well. And that's okay. Okay, so what I'm going to do next, get some extra virgin olive oil or some grapeseed oil. You can just put a little bit on your, well, I put a lot on my hands. And then just kind of put it in here like that. Okay, and I'm going to wash my hands. What you want to do, this is considered a tea towel. So basically pour that, put that over. And it doesn't matter if you have a few tea towels. I mean, this is a tea towel as well, which is nice, light kitchen cloth. And put it over, and then you take some plastic, make sure. And I usually do it the other way, but this way works. Either way, it works fine. You can put the plastic over this way, or you could put it. Main thing you want to do is you want it to breathe a little. You also want it to have warmth. Okay? And then I'm going to set this aside like this, and then make sure. And I'm going to probably put it in the oven later, and then we'll bake it at a later time. Okay, so now we're going to get ready for the sweet potato pie. There's a couple ways of going with the sweet potato pie. The sweet potato pie, you can make it traditional, or you can make it non-traditional. So I'm going to do a non-traditional way, taking all the traditions and incorporating all the old traditions with the new traditions. Sweet potato pies, there's been pies that are made with animal fat, lard, animal fat, suet is what they called it, and that's how they used to make the pies in the past, and butter, you could use butter. You can make a crumb, like a graham cracker if you want a lighter pie, but I'm going to do a regular, nice, crusted, flaky, crusted sweet potato pie. So, I'm going to heat up some milk here. I'm going to start off with the crust. So, I'm going to heat up some milk, right? Just a little bit. I don't need a lot. So, I'm going to go ahead. Actually, I might put some inside with my sweet potato. Ice water, ready for it to come out when it's heated up, because I want to use cold water. So, you want to. So, I'm going to flavor up. I'm going to flavor up my crust. So, I have some anise. Okay. I'm going to put a couple of things of anise. Okay. I'm going to put like one clove or maybe, maybe two cloves. Two whole cloves in there. Then I want to give it my a little bit of a kick. So I'm going to put like 2, 4, 6, 7 peppercorns. Yeah, seven's a good number. So 7 peppercorns. Then I'm going to take some cardamom. So I want to put a little bit, I want to put some flavor into my, put some flavor. Put some flavor in there. So this is cardamom. Cardamom is kind of pricey, but you know, it's good to have. So I'm going to go ahead and crush, lightly crush it on my bench that I haven't washed or cleaned off, which you should clean it off in between. So I got the seeds in there. I'm going to stick those in there.